Hello everyone, amateur meteorologist First and Weather here. It is August 17, 2019, and this is going to be another weather discussion video. I'll be looking at the pattern for the next couple of weeks or so. I know, and we'll also be looking at the tropics and what's going on, actually pretty close to the North Carolina and Virginia coastline, and that should pretty much sum up this video. So this won't really be a forecast video for like the winter or the fall or any type of long range discussion. This will just be a short range discussion as what's going on right now and why it's happening. So let's get started into the video. This is the GFS 500 millibar geopotential height valid. This is the 12Z GFS run valid August 17th. And this is just over the next few days to show you what's going on. And as you can see, the anticipated, you know, that cold over the below average temperatures over the Midwest were kind of, you know, overdone, I feel like, this for this month. They were not really that impressive. There were cold shots, but they were not really that impressive. If I get my pen and get color black, the troughs really were only the below average temperatures were really only focused in this area right up here. It was really only the extreme northern portion of the country where those troughs really were able to dig in and provide some much below average temperatures. And as you can see, that's what this run is showing for the next few days, with that trough right here only really scraping the northern part of the country, while areas such as the Northeast, Mid-Atlantic, and Southeast, and also lower portions of the Midwest really just see just typical summertime conditions, temperatures just a few degrees above average. So here is the CFS temperature anomaly for the next 4 weeks. And as you can see, for the first week, this is from August 17th. I know it's a bit hard to see, but this is from August 17th to the 24th of August. As you can see, it pretty much has the entire country with above average temperatures, and it is reflecting those shallow troughs over Canada coming down into the northern part of the country, which is why this area is around average, just slightly below average. Second week, it amplifies that ridge in the southwest, or the extreme western portion of the country, so a pattern more like this. And then it again has those shallow troughs right here, which are providing those brief shots of cold air, keeping things average to slightly below average right here. And then in the third week, this is from the 31st of August to the 7th of September, and it has a more typical, or not a typical, but more extreme sort of troughing pattern over the east and ridging pattern over the west. The jet stream flow becomes more like this. And I think this is definitely way overdone. This is not going to happen in September. You can have these things happen occasionally where this happens for a few days. But in September, it's really rare to see persistent troughing in the east for a week or more, and even for 2 weeks, as this model is showing. And as we've seen over the past couple, or as we've seen with this month, the model has tended to overdo the cold for the eastern part of the country. So I think this is definitely a bit overdone. I think what it'll be more like is something like this. And you'll just have average seasonal, slightly below average conditions only in this part of the country, while the rest of the area stays mild with temperatures generally above average. And the same thing goes for the 7th of September through the 14th of September. So let's look at the tropics. Why is everything so quiet? Usually in August, you see things really ramping up, you know, really start to see the second half of hurricane season turn into high gear with lots of named storms. And the reason is we've had very below average or seasonally cool waters off of the coast of Africa. And as you can see, as I've highlighted right here, we have below average temperature anomalies for this wide area. And this is where a lot of those waves come off the coast of Africa and then form and then go like this, or fizzle out and go like this. And this is really the starting point of all that tropical activity. And you can also get storms forming here, but usually at this time of year, they come off of Africa, and that area has just been very unconductive or unfavorable for storm development, especially in the tropical nature. So that's why things have been quiet. And it looks like that for the next week or so, at least, that things will remain quiet over the eastern part of the Atlantic. Now, one thing I do want to note is that we do have some potential activity off the southeastern coast. We have 90, 97L, which is an invest, And again, the National Weather Service or the Hurricane Center only has about a 1 in 10% chance of it developing, so really not much of a big threat. It's mainly going to be just a heavy rainmaker. As you can see, the models have it basically track right along the South Carolina, North Carolina border before veering off to the northeast. And again, it's a very small chance of it turning into anything really tropical or meaningful. So again, the main risk will just be heavy rains and a flash flooding risk in thunderstorms that, pack a really heavy punch. And so this is the NAM GIF. As you can see, it actually does pick up on some rotation right over here. Maybe I think if you can pick it out, if you have a good eye, you can see that rotation going like this. So again, this definitely has some tropical characteristics, but it really won't be enough for it to be called a tropical storm or tropical depression the way it looks like right now. And it will essentially mostly be a heavy rainmaker. You can see those pockets of heavy thunderstorms that are along the North Carolina and southeastern South Carolina border. But since the storm will be to the east of the border, the main part will be in the northeastern quadrant, since it does have those tropical characteristics, which fortunately for areas that don't want to see flash flooding is off the Atlantic Ocean. So it looks like if it stays this way, the borders of North Carolina and South Carolina should be mostly spared in terms of extremely heavy rainfall, if because the Atlantic will be seeing actually much heavier rainfall rates than this area. However, there still is the potential to see, 1, 2, maybe 3 inches of rainfall in isolated areas, as is typical with thunderstorms. The rainfall amounts are heavy, are extremely isolate or are heavily specialized. Some area can see 0 inches of rain, the other area can see 2, 3 inches of rain in a matter of minutes. So this is the NAM rainfall or total accumulated precip forecast until 9Z Monday. As you can see, again, the brunt of the rainfall is off the coast. However, there are, sections, especially the Outer Banks, that get, 3, 4, maybe even 5 inches of rain in isolated pockets. But after you go around 50 miles off the coast, there's a sharp cutoff where we just see, scattered showers and not really that much of a big deal. So again, in summary, this is just, a nuisance, not really a big troublemaker whatsoever. This will just be, another system that people on the coast are really used to. So that pretty much sums up this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.